أشهد أن محمد رسول الله.
الحمد لله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، نحمده ونشكره ونستعين به ونستغفره ونعوذ به من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، أكمل لنا ديننا وأتم علينا نعمته ورضي لنا الإسلام دينا. وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، أرسله الله شاهدا ومبشرا ونذيرا وداعيا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجا منيرا. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وتابعيه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. عباد الله، أوصيكم وإياي بتقوى الله، وأحثكم على طاعته، وأستفتح بالذي هو خير. Praise be to Allah. Glory is His, the cherisher and sustainer of the universe. He perfected our faith for us, completed His favor upon us, and chose Islam for us as our religion. Praise be to Allah. We seek His help, ask for His forgiveness, and repent to Him. We seek refuge with Allah from the evils within ourselves and from the burden of our evil deeds. He whom Allah guides will never be misled. He whom Allah leaves to stray will never find one to guide him. I bear witness that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah. Glory is His alone, having no partners. And that Prophet Muhammad, may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, is his servant and messenger, who was sent by Allah as a witness, a bearer of glad tidings, a warner calling unto Allah by his leave, and a guiding light. May the peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, his household, his companions, and all those who follow his guidance until the day of judgment. Servants of Allah, be conscious of Allah. Observe your duties to Him and obey His commands. Today's sermon is about the Qur'an. Allah, glory is His, said in Surah Al-Baqarah, chapter 2, verse 121, الَّذِينَ آتَيْنَاهُمُ الْكِتَابَ يَتْلُونَهُ حَقَّ تِلَاوَتِهِ أُولَٰئِكَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِهِ وَمَنْ يَكْفُرْ بِهِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ. Those to whom we have given the scripture, who recite and follow it as it deserves, are the ones who truly believe in it. Those who deny its truth will be the losers. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the Arabic word yatlunahu is often translated to recite it, but it actually means to recite it and to follow it. Allah, glory is His, said in Surah Al-Isra, chapter 17, verse 9, إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ يَهْدِي لِلَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَمُ وَيُبَشِّرُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ الَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ الصَّالِحَاتِ أَنَّ لَهُمْ أَجْرًا كَبِيرًا. This Quran does show the straightest way. It gives the believers who do right the glad tidings that they will have a great reward. Brothers and sisters in Islam, to recite the Quran is to follow its guidance. To recite the Quran is to act upon its teachings. To recite the Quran is to change our behavior according to the Quran's manifest light. To recite the Quran is to put its words to practice. To recite the Quran is to reflect on the meanings of its verses and ponder over its enlightenment. Allah, glory is His, said in Surah Sa'd, chapter 38, verse 29, addressing Prophet Muhammad, may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, كِتَابٌ أَنْزَلْنَاهُ إِلَيْكَ مُبَارَكٌ لِيَتْدَبَّرُوا آيَاتِهِ وَلِيَتَذَكَّرَ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. A blessed scripture, which we have sent down to you, so that people may think about its messages, and those with understanding take heed. May the light of the Quran fill our hearts and guide us to the straight path. I say this and ask Allah to forgive me and forgive you. Supplicate to Allah with the conviction that He will answer. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم عباد الله اتقوا الله فإنه من يتقي الله يجعل له مخرجا ويرزقه من حيث لا يحتسب servants of Allah be conscious of Allah and He will make ways out for you from every hardship and provide for you from sources that you never anticipated or even imagined. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah glory is His, said in Surah Al-Jumu'ah, chapter 62, verse 5, about the Jews who do not follow the Torah. مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ حُمِّلُوا التَّوْرَاةَ ثُمَّ لَمْ يَحْمِلُوهَا كَمَثَلِ الْحِمَارِ يَحْمِلُ أَسْفَارًا بِئْسَ مَثَلُ الْقَوْمِ الَّذِينَ كَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الظَّالِمِينَ Those who have been charged to obey the Torah but did not do so are like donkeys carrying books. They do not understand what is written in them. How mean-spirited are such people who disobey Allah's revelations. Allah does not guide the evildoers. Now the same could be said about Muslims who do not follow the Quran. We Muslims have been charged to obey the Quran. And if we do not do so, we would be like donkeys carrying books, not understanding what is written in them. Sadly, many Muslims place copies of the Quran on shelves at home, collecting dust. We have to remember that the Quran is to be read and followed every day of the year, not just during the month of Ramadan, but throughout the year. Knowledge of Arabic is not essential, as the translations of the words of the Quran are available in every language. I am proud to say that I have recorded a recitation of the Quran in Arabic and an English translation. And thank God I am the only one worldwide who did this. I read the verse in Arabic and I read its translation in English. It is available on YouTube, on Deezer, on Apple Music, and on Spotify, and available. So knowledge of Arabic is not important. Best translation is actually to the language of action. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the Quran was sent to the whole mankind, not only to Muslims. The Quran has the solutions for all the problems of the world. All we need to do is to follow its guidance. For example, to end the third world poverty, we should pay the alms, in Arabic as zakah, and spend on charity. Allah glory is His, said in Surah Al-Baqarah, chapter 2, verse 43, وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةَ وَارْكَعُوا مَعَ الرَّاكِعِينَ Keep up the prayer, pay the prescribed alms, and bow down in worship with those who bow. Another example, to abolish the third world massive debts, we should eliminate usury. Allah glory is He said in Surah Al-Baqarah, chapter 2, verse 278, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهِ وَذَرُوا مَا بَقِيَ مِنَ الرِّبَى إِن كُنْتُم مُؤْمِنِينَ You who believe, be conscious of Allah and give up any outstanding dues from usury if you are true believers. Another example, to improve the state of the environment, we should not indulge in extravagant lifestyle and should not waste energy. Allah glory is His, said in Surah Al-A'raf, chapter 7, verse 31, وَكُلُوا وَاشْرَبُوا وَلَا تُسْرِفُوا إنه لا يحب المسرفين. Eat and drink, but do not be extravagant. Allah does not like extravagant people. Brothers and sisters in Islam, those were only a few examples, but the Quran is full of similar guidance. May Allah glory is His guide us to follow the teachings of the Quran and to be among those who listen and follow the best of what they hear. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه اللهم أصلح لنا ديننا الذي هو عصمة أمرنا وأصلح لنا دنيانا التي فيها معاشنا وأصلح لنا آخرتنا التي إليها معادنا واجعل الحياة زيادة لنا في كل خير واجعل الموت راحة لنا من كل شر اللهم لا تدع لنا في هذا اليوم العظيم ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا عيبا إلا سترته ولا هما إلا فرجته ولا دينا إلا قضيته ولا مريضا إلا شفيته ولا ميتا إلا رحمته ولا حاجة لنا إلا يسرتها يا رب العالمين. Servants of Allah, Allah enjoins justice, good conduct, and providing for kinsfolk. He deplores lewdness, obscenity, and oppression. He advises you so that you may take heed. Remember Allah, and He will remember you. Ask Him for forgiveness, and He will forgive you. وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةِ.